Three of our top agents had been uncovered in Warsaw. Although the men had succeeded in hiding in the sewers, the damage was very serious.
Their shoes were ruined forever.
My mission was to prevent secret information from falling into the Germans' hands at any cost. I was smuggled in, unarmed, and disguised.
Here we see Violette expertly disguised as Groucho Marx.
I had to find the men before the Gestapo did. If there was no way out, I had to silence them. Those were my orders.
Well, MI5 knows her strengths, at least.
It was suspected that their hiding place was in a section of the sewers near the ghetto. It would not be easy to get there. The Nazis were in the process of cleaning out the entire ghetto.
That's awfully community-minded of the... Oh, wait. We're back in our regular murdering clothes and deep in the heart of occupied Poland. Looks like three of our fellow agents slipped up and the Nazi fuzz is hot on their heels. Which means Violette has to do what she does best. Leave a suspicious trail of corpses straight to them. By this time, the German occupation troops in Poland would likely have been using the local Zloty rather than the German Reichsmark or even the Reich's credit treasury note from other occupied nations. So using the fixed exchange rate that Germany enforced at 1 Reichsmark to 2 Zloty, he's suggesting 3,000 Reichsmarks for the morphine and cigarettes. Using the lowest salary I could find for an SS Rotenführer, he'd be making around 78 marks a month. So really, those numbers don't make any sense no matter how you look at it. In other news, I think I hear a radio. I'll smash this fuse box and dispatch the first guard just before he enters back into the light. His partner is still unable to see his target due to a lack of explosives. Maybe he should have brought flares instead. He's carrying a shiny key we'll need below, and it seems that the Nazis have confiscated a silenced Colt from someone in the ghetto. Let's just make sure it works. Not only is it capable of destroying barrels, it can also cause pocket watches to appear. Now that explosion gained us a tad bit of attention, which would normally be a bad thing, but these guards have an odd tendency to merge into a single super soldat. Turns out, four eyes and two guns does not make them any better at looking behind them. Up this ladder, we find a smorgasbord of items, a letter, our first vial of morphine, and a lighter. You may have noticed that we are now sporting an additional morphine silhouette in the lower left corner. Since our stealth is maxed, I've begun pouring upgrade stars into the morphine stat, so we're now capable of carrying up to two vials at once.
Too late. One of the agents had been caught, and the Gestapo knows how to make people talk. In other words, the man was as good as dead. I had to follow them to the prison, but first I had to find the other agents.
Looks like Agent Radek has made a mess of things, but as Violette says, we have more important things to worry about right now. We end up back in the giant circular pit we started at on the second story. Payday Lone Nazi is still hanging out in the center, so I can't run, but we will have the chance to pick up a second vial of morphine on our meandering circuit around this sepulcher. His supplier is nowhere to be found, but I'm sure they would both be red in the face to discover a fortune in morphine was sitting in the sewer water just above their heads. Next, we pass through an oddly configured sewer juncture and into the tunnels themselves, where we'll find a few more economically minded Nazis.
Einen haben sie schon gefunden und weggeschleppt. Der zweite hat sich kurz vorher selbst vergiftet. Das heißt, einer fehlt noch. Er muss sich hier unten irgendwo versteckt haben. Soweit ich gehört habe, ist er aber verletzt. Bald kann er also nicht kommen. Wir kriegen bestimmt alle ein Abzeichen, wenn wir den auch noch erwischen. Sturmbannführer Henkel hat sogar schon das Ritterkreuz.
Das kann der sich sonst wo reinstecken. Die Spione gehen schon früh genug kaputt. Genau wie wir alle.
Vorsicht! Das ist Hochverrat.
Und wenn schon? Heutzutage ist es doch schon Hochverrat, wenn man seine Jacke falsch geknöpft hat.
Was redest du denn da? Bist du verrückt geworden?
Der Sturmbannführer darf mir den Arsch küssen. Ich weiß von seinem ganzen krummen Geschäften. Der würde sich nie wagen, mich vor Gericht zu stellen.
Was soll der Quatsch? Pass auf, wenn das in die falschen Ohren gerät, bist du dran.
Hier hat jeder ihn in der Tasche, mein Junge. Lass mich in Ruhe mit dem Scheiß. Ich gehe noch ein paar Runden und dann können sie mich alle.
Wir sollen aber die Stellung halten, hat der Scharführer gesagt.
Ich hab nichts gehört. Und du auch nicht.
Das gibt sicher noch Ärger.
Und wenn schon. Bubi, du hast wohl den Warschau-Koller. Ärger? Dass ich nicht lache. Geh mal zum Ivan rüber. Da kochen sie dir das Wasser im Arsch.
Luckily for us, these two conveniently missed the dying agent while setting up a floodlight beside him.
Andrei Korchak, codename Yosef. His fight was over. The man was seriously wounded. But he did not want to swallow his pill. Home is always in the wrong direction, and Yosef would never make it out of here. I had no choice, and there was something I needed from him.
Tu crois qu'elle nous entend?
Elle est complètement dans les vapes. Une raison de plus d'en finir au plus vite. Qui sait si elle se réveillera jamais?
Pas juste la tuer. Pourquoi donc es-tu revenu, Paul?
Ils pressent tout le monde comme un citron. Ils ont défoncé toutes les dents d'Henri, et encore, il a eu de la chance. Deux hommes ont été descendus. Ils menacent de faire un massacre si personne ne leur dit où elle se cache. Maurice, ils sont sérieux. Il faut la leur livrer.
Non, elle est unique. Nous ne devons pas l'abandonner, Paul. Tu sais ce qu'ils lui feront?
As my superior liked to say, there's only one thing worse than a captured agent. A captured agent without cyanide. I had to get this pill to the third agent.
He also likes to say an injured and fully extractable agent is much preferred over both. They did give you the option of rescuing them, Violette. You do remember that, right? This explosion will set off the poisonous gas canister ahead and prove once and for all that Nazis cannot see the green end of the visible spectrum. While I'm passing by, I might as well break this fuse box. Not like anybody's gonna be using it anytime soon. Certainly not Agent Yosef. Violette made certain of that. We'll We'll wait here until the light flickers out once again, and then move forward to hide in the center of this pile of garbage. When the first guard patrols past us, we'll dispatch him and leave him wherever he lies.
Junge, Junge, so viel Spatz.
Usually I'd give this Nazi a bit of lead to think about, but I feel a little extra sneaky today, so let's do it properly. He doesn't patrol, has his back protected, stands in front of a light source, and to top it all off, he has a flashlight that activates when he's alerted. We can disable the light source from here, then head back up and see what we can do about the rest. Looks like hours on watch in the sewer have made him less than vigilant. So long as we make sure there's nothing between us and him, I can whistle to get him a little more exposed.
Was war das?
He doesn't move far, but that's alright. It's far enough for me. And now that he's dealt with, we'll be on our way. This next guard has an odd tendency to freeze in his alert animation, so it's probably for the best that we took the last fella out silently. Explosions for one, and poison for the other. So long as we move quickly, they won't see us when we first enter. As long as this guard turns, and the other one isn't looking, I can move forward. This area is disappointingly well lit, but oddly enough, this bridge counts as shadowed.
It was Yerzha Yarkovich. Codename Wojciech. His skin showed red spots. He had taken cyanide.
Tu sais ce qu'ils lui feront? On ne peut pas le permettre. Et elle pourrait nous être utile. Ne sois pas idiot, Paul.
Non, on ne peut plus prendre ce risque. Les SS sont déjà sur notre piste. Nos camarades ont peur pour leur famille. Ils sont terrorisés.
Tu ne crois pas que je le suis? Nous ne devons pas nous précipiter. Tu es trop nerveux. Nous avons bien fait. Aurions-nous dû la laisser mourir?
Regarde-la. Ce n'est pas la peine. Elle est plus morte que vive. Tu veux sacrifier tout un village, les femmes et les enfants?
Elle a un ange gardien puissant. Il nous a menés à elle pour que nous l'aidions. Son destin est le nôtre. Ne le vois-tu pas?
Il ne faut pas croire tout ce que tu vois.
Well, Angel might be a stretch, but Violette certainly has a guardian directing her actions. There's a signet ring on the ground here, along with a vial of morphine to replace the one we've just used, and a second gas mask if you failed to pick up the first. The first guard has a key for the exit, and the signs ahead suggest that I might want to put on our gas mask. This entire mission has a tendency to put fuse boxes beyond the enemies they light up, which is a little odd and time-consuming.
Hey, Friedrich. So langsam habe ich die Schnauze voll. Geht dir das Patrouillieren hier unten nicht auch allmählich gegen den Strich?
Vorsicht, die Wände haben manchmal Ohren.
Aber doch nicht hier. Wer ist schon so verrückt, freiwillig in dieser dreckigen Jauche herumzukriechen?
Du zum Beispiel.
Pah, so eine Scheiße. Das passiert mir nicht nochmal.
Wegen 5 Minuten. Wegen dämlicher 5 Minuten.
So ein Mist.
Tja, ich hätte auch viel lieber oben mit aufgeräumt. Aber keine Sorge, da sind noch genug übrig. Aber die Spionen brauchen wir unbedingt liegen.
Wird eigentlich, falls sie sich fürchten.
Wie meinst du das?
Na, falls sie nicht sehen wollen. Es gibt ja solche und solche. Was wird dann eigentlich genau mit ihnen gemacht bei der Gestapo?
Meistens gibt es erstmal natürlich die Prügel. Dann ein paar Tage aushungern in der Dunkelzelle. Fingernägel abziehen. Amputationen, Elektroschocks, Injizieren von Erregern und so weiter.
Mein Gott, das ist nicht dein Ernst.
Und wie? Die Arme ist doch nicht anders verdient. Wenn einer von denen versucht, hier durchzukommen, verpasse ich ihm selbst eine. Da kannst du dir sicher sein.
Wenn du meinst, Hauptsache wir sind hier bald aus dem Drecksloch raus.
Oh, you'll both be getting out of this filthy hole soon enough, courtesy of 2 new filthy holes. I would imagine this is the biogas they were referring to earlier, which really didn't come into production until after World War II. Considering the apparatus around us, however, it's possible that these are early Imhoff anaerobic digestion tanks. That, or Replay Studios wanted an excuse to make us wear a gas mask again. After grabbing a Knight's Cross from these 2 barrels, we can circle around and clear the last of the guards in this room. With him dead, we're free to sprint out of the biogas facility and into our final refuge of the mission. You'll notice that the last time I passed by this locker, while the 2 fellows below were chatting, I switched out for the Luger handgun. Since I only need it for the final guard, I figured I'd show you how it operates. Here's a hint. It's like the Colt, but much, much louder. Won't need the gas mask in this next chamber, so off it goes. This vault takes some serious planning, as the light is placed in a manner to cause areas that possess shadows on the ground to occasionally not offer protection. In addition, we'll see a new enemy type that can make it even worse. We've seen him in flash-forward, flashback, hallucination, what have yous, but here he is in the standard flashback flesh. That flamethrower can cause 2 serious problems for us if it's used. First, it causes relatively severe damage, which is understandable. Second, it will absolutely crush my frame rate. Therefore, we're going to go ahead and kill him in the most expedient way possible. Of course, as soon as these 2 are down, the game will throw a 2nd pair at us, so we need to duck into cover immediately.
Hey, stay out, man!
Scheiße! Raus, Jungs!
That's the safest way to remove the flamethrower soldiers, but there is an additional option that we don't have with your average guard. As soon as this final jerk waddles his way into range, I'll open fire with the Luger and show you what I mean. As far as I can tell, it takes 2 shots to cause the fuel tank on his back to explode, and there's simply no indication that you hit with the first. We'll duck down to the left here and grab pilot watch, and then we'll run around, up and around to complete the mission.